see what this girl can do. You ready?
Yep.
We'll pass and go. Holy, this thing can move. Holy, this thing can fucking move.
Jesus Christ. I just can't.
It's fucking too fast, eh?
I can follow. It's... wow.
Oh my god! I have never flown a ship like this. My god. What an absolute fucking alien. Bringing a Pyre Gladius, nice. So let's go for round two here. So if I were you, I would stay a little further away, although I wouldn't want to be fighting this thing right now, that's for sure. Time to control the fight. There's the wobble I was talking about. Push in, push in, push in. My gunpowder. Corkscrew to get away from everything. But definitely took some hits there. I want to get right up on you here. And I want to get in the slot. Nice, good backup. I'm obviously taking some damage here. This is a really close fight. Kind of reverse the angle. Not a good spot for me. Preno's over. Hey! There it is! So let's talk Cartual. So initially, I haven't flown the ship in a while, and I remember that this thing uses what's known as vector thrust, essentially, right? So the main engines articulate like its maneuvering thrusters, so you get a tremendous amount of g-force from almost all directions, like it's almost bi-directional, but you still have a stronger pitch under flight conditions, right? So you still want to fight in pitch like all the other ships, but the thing with the Cartual, a little desync there, the thing with the Cartual is it's designed to be a slot fighter. I call it a slot fighter, which basically you don't want to be engaging unless you're basically fighting for the slot. If you get in front of people, you really don't have a lot of hit points. And the big problem I find with the Cartual is its front face profile is the largest, and that's what you're going to be presenting towards an enemy. So it is very difficult to hit in the sense that if you can close the gap, close the distance, right? Like Bray right here is in a good position. He's got some damage coming in because I actually need to close the distance. I'm getting a little bit comfortable at longer range because I'm getting lots of applied damage, but it's not smart because that's what costs the fight on the second fight, which we'll go back to. We'll go back and take a look at that fight. But this is the third fight, so I wanted to kind of start the process of talking about what's going on here. And the thing I noticed about the Carte du Wall is there's the kill, is it wants to stay sub 100, 200 meters. And it can do that because it has such a strong main thruster. So let's go back and take a look at the second fight, which was the loss, and find out what happened here that we were unable to get the kill, right? So here we go into the merge. Again, always fighting in pitch as we come into our target. Here's the roll, rolling myself, and watch the distance here. Watch the distance. So we're sitting around 450. Again, our front face profile right now is just getting slammed, right? I've got a good position here, but I let him get away from me. Again, right? Getting a little bit nervous here, doing a bit of an S-turn there, trying to get that slot position again, getting some more damage on him. And again, we're back to 300, 400 meters. Now we're getting a little closer. We're getting at like 200. Not a bad spot. This is good here, but I fucked up on my power management and I lost some gunpowder. And here is another mistake. I'm doing a lot of rolls. I'm doing a lot of trying to evasive flying. But it's, again, the highest percentage of damage that you're going to take from this thing is front-facing, right? So a lot of these aileron rolls and corkscrews and stuff like that, you're not really going to shake too much damage. What's going to shake damage on this thing is getting right here, nice and close. So that's a good position that I was in, but again, he got some distance on me, right? Bray's no fool. He knows, like, I'm not going to let you sit there and roll around me. So again, right, mistake number one for me was not closing my distance, not being as aggressive as I need to be, right? Because if I stay at range, if I stay at my 200, 300, 400 meter range, the Gladius is going to have that edge, right? And those two size four guns just don't do enough damage. You know, again, I'm over-rotating, I'm over-emphasizing my movements because I'm a little bit nervous that I'm getting hit, and I'm thinking to myself, like, oh, shit, you know what I mean? There it is. So the failure here was incorrect range control, just because, I mean, I've never flown this thing. It's been a long fucking time, and I couldn't believe the responsiveness that this ship had, but the big downfall was I wasn't aggressive enough. If you fly the Carte du Wall, you have to be extremely aggressive. I picked this moment in the fight because it kind of showcases the dynamic between this fight, which is the reason why I ended up losing. I like my position here, but I'm not, like, here's where I want to be. And with the Carte du Wall, you have the acceleration to pull and stay in that position, but here he gets away from me, right? And that's the big problem. And as I apex around that corner, I allow him to lose target again. So here it is again in slow motion, and I just kind of want to freeze frame this for a second. As I'm losing my distance on him, I'm starting to get sucked into what's called flying flat. And flying flat means I'm too close, like I'm too tight on my nose angle with him, so we're lined up on each other too tight. I should be coming at him at a more wide angle. I made a video called Approach Angles, or Approach Angles with a Buccaneer, and my approach angle was so tight that our flight path was almost like a joust, and that's what caused the majority of these engagements for me to lose range. I should have came at a wider angle, had a stronger position as I rolled into the corners, like this position here, but again, too far away, right? So all in all, not a bad fight. This is a good position here. I'm nice and close, but again, he's starting to get away from me and I'm letting him go, and I start to go into a counter maneuver. I start flipping. I'm basically flying this thing like I traditionally fly my arrow, but I have four times the hit surface profile when it comes to flying a ship like this compared to the arrow. So really something to consider when flying the Carte du Wall is you want to be really, really, really aggressive. All right, guys, that's all for today. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. All in all, the Carte du Wall is performing quite well. Big things to consider using those main thrusters is if you're going to fly this thing, I want you to get so close. I want you to be so aggressive with this thing that you don't even let the opponent breathe. The very first fight is a good example of me not letting my opponent breathe. Second fight, not so much. Some points to improve. Third fight, I was able to start dialing it in a little closer. But all in all, Carte du Wall is a pretty interesting ship. Definitely something worth paying attention to. Two size four guns, probably not the greatest, but that's just the way she rolls. Don't forget, guys, the sponsor for the stream is Predator Mounts. So if you want to get yourself a nice set of Predator Mounts or some mounts for joysticks and stuff like that, check on predatormounts.com and check the code Avenger1 to get 5% off anything. It's the sponsor for the stream, guys. It's what I use. He's a great guy, and he's got some fucking great stuff, right? So definitely check him out if you're in the market for some mounts. I will see all of you folks on stream, hopefully, and I will definitely see you guys out in the next video. I was Avenger1, and I'll see you next time.